Again, Emily?
Lord, I can't believe that child.
Well, you better hurry up. There's a big storm heading this way.
Now, what was it you wanted me to do?
I did it myself.
Oh.
I wanted a hand with these here clothes before the storm blew them all away.
I'm sorry, Aunt Em. I didn't
think. No, you never do, child. Now we're fixing for a twister and you're playing games with that dog. And in your Sunday dress too. Serves you right if you both blew away.
I imagine it would.
What was that?
Oh, I'm not much help around here for you and Uncle Henry. Always daydreaming and stuff. I bet it would be a big load off your back if I did blow away, wouldn't it?
I imagine it would.
It would?
I love you.
Just
dead?
Yeah, and I don't think she's gonna like that.
Congratulations!
You just killed the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh no!
Oh yeah.
Girl, I'm gonna wear white to her funeral.
I didn't mean to kill nobody.
Well, what's going on here?
Annabelle! Let me get your autograph, girl.
Who are you?
The Good Witch of the North.
The Good Witch of the North?
Maybe you know me better by my stage name. Annabelle, the feel-good girl.
Your stage name?
Yes, I have a magic act. I do tricks.
Does she ever?
You better cool it before I turn you into something.
Adderpearl, look, this child here, she didn't want to set her house on your sister, Evelyn.
Oh!
That is old Evelyn, ain't it?
Yes, I'd recognize those tacky pantyhose of hers anywhere.
Well, that means there's only three witches left in Oz. Me, the Good Witch of the North, and my sister, Glinda. You ought to go see her act, honey, and then there's Evelyn.
Evelyn.
You better watch out for her, child. She is a real downer. But now let's get down to business. What is your name?
Well, my name is...
Wait! Don't tell me. I'll just read your mind.
What?
Read your mind. I won't ask any questions, but in my mind, I shall know your name, and that name is Shirley.
No.
Denise.
No.
Starletta.
No.
Yearly.
No.
Mary Bethune.
No, my name.
Just tell me your name, child. You can't win them all now, can you? Ebony, bibbity, more of the same now. We're getting to see the name Dorothy.
You call that magic?
Listen, I'm doing the best I can.
Then you'll help me get back to Kansas?
Kansas? I don't think so. That includes transporting a minor across state lines. Maybe you ought to go see the WIZ.
Yeah, she ought to go see the WIZ.
Silver slipper, would you?
I hope you don't mind a pair of secondhand shoes.
I never had a pair this beautiful.
But you have to promise me not to take them off before you get home.
All right, I promise, but why?
Because they've got some really secret powers.
To do what?
Well, I don't know. That's the secret.
Well, they're just my size anyway.
And the kiss?
Aww.
We'll protect you wherever you go, except in the poppy fields.
What's wrong with poppies?
Oh, those kinds have put you to sleep for hundreds of years. You're waking up and your clothes all out of style. It's horrible. But I must go. With a wave of my wand, I shall disappear on you. Just gonna wave this thing about 3 or 4 more times than ever in Christmas. What the hell is going on here? You see, trouble is, child, I ain't been disappearing much lately. I've been taking the bus.
Done it again, y'all.
But she didn't tell me how to get to Emerald City.
Oh, darling.
You can't miss it.
I can't?
No.
You see that road of yellow bricks?
Right.
Just follow that for about 2 days now.
Right.
But watch out for a lot of spooky things.
Like what?
Careful of those awful collider people.
Watch out for them terrible flying monkeys.
Most of all, watch out for that evil old wicked witch of the west. That girl is everything.
Outside of that, have a nice trip.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you.
No, I know scarecrows can't talk.
Hey, honey, you got any spare change?
What?
I said, you got any spare change? Loose bread? Anything to like get my head together?
Now, what would a scarecrow do with money?
Well, I'm saving up to buy me some brains.
That's silly. You can't buy brains.
You can't?
No.
Well, how about that?
What do you want brains for anyway? Isn't it any fun being a scarecrow?
Well, I thought it would be, but after 15 minutes of sitting up here on this pole, I realized I wasn't going anyplace.
Scarecrow, how would you like to get down off that pole?
I thought you'd never ask. Just pull on that vine back there. Man, it sure feels good to be on my own two feet again.
You haven't had it easy, have you?
Honey, you know it.
Handle it.
over there.
What should we do?
Go over there.
No, Scarecrow. Somebody needs help. What is it?
Don't look like an is to me. Looks more like a was.
Oil, oil. I need oil, oil, oil.
He needs oil.
Oh, please, miss. There's some over there in that little shack.
I'll get it.
No, Dorothy, wait.
Hi.
Man, I've seen some spaced out garbage cans in my day.
I found it, Tin Man. Now what?
Now what? Shopper, till a wicked old witch put a spell on my axe.
A spell?
Yeah, and she really did some number. Let me tell you, one day I was chopping down the street and that axe done slipped and cut off my left leg.
Ain't that something?
Yeah, I thought so too. So I went to this here tinsmith I knew and I said, hey man, you think you can fix me up with a tin leg? Well, he did. And so the next day, I'm back chopping, doing my thing, and damn if that axe slipped and cut off my right leg. So, I'm back to the tinsmith to get me another leg.
Now at no time did it dawn upon you to just get a new axe.
Well, before I knew it, bit by bit, I was all made out of tin. And that's how the story came about.
You poor man.
Well, you can't have everything.
And that's the truth.
God honest truth.
Cross your heart.
I can't do that.
I knew it. You was jiving us all along. Come on, Dorothy.
No, no, wait. I can't cross my heart, 'cause I don't have a heart.
You don't have a heart?
Well, it didn't always come with a suit. You know, nowadays it's enough just being good looking.
Then come with us to Emerald City and see the great Wiz. They say he could do most anything for anybody.
Yeah? Well, show me the way then.
The king of the jungle?
Well, you don't see no other cat begging for the gig, do you?
Man, you got a yellow streak a mile wide.
It is not. It's my mane. I just had it touched up this morning.
You coward, going around roaring at people, you ought to be ashamed.
I am, but it's not my fault. No, wait. I was an only cub. Daddy left home when I was born. And Mama was such a strong lady. It was either do this or don't do that.
You call that pause clean? Leak behind your ears, child, so you don't get no dessert.
And all I ever got was a bunch of schizophrenic phobias.
Wow. Where'd you get all them big words from?
My owl.
What owl?
Well, I've been seeing a high price style for 3 years now.
An owl.
Yes, an owl. In Ari's time, you didn't realize how much bread that runs into.
And this here, owl, what does he say in answer to your disgraceful self?
Well, owls don't give answers. They just ask questions like, who? So, at heart, I'll never be nothing but a big old scaredy cat.
Oh, it could be worse. I mean, at least you have a heart.
Yeah, at least you've got a brain. Even if it is making him a pretty mixed up cat.
Man, what good's the heart? What good's the brain if he ain't got no courage?
You know, maybe, just maybe, if you came with us and saw the great Wiz, he can give you some courage. Just like that.
In only one session? Gentlemen. Little mama, of course. May I fill out your foursome? Where are we?
I think we're lost.
What makes you say that?
Because you don't know where we are.
Then let's go this way.
Ease on down, ease on down the road. Ease on down, ease on down the road.
This one's got rhythm. Oh, mama.
Oh, look, there's a little ugly one.
It can't be Halloween.
I'm sorry, mama. I didn't mean that.
Why is it getting so dark?
Beats me.
It's nowhere near sundown yet.
I know. Oh, this is that forest where those colliders live.
What's a collider?
I was afraid you was gonna ask that. Oh, oh, Mama, Mama, that's you, Mama.
Come on, man.
That was so close for comfort.
Tin Man?
Yes, honey?
You sure saved us all.
Oh, it wasn't no big thing.
And Scarecrow, you sure kept your cool, too.
Well, what can I say?
Yeah, that's right. The offense always gets the headlines. Nobody ever talks about the defense anymore.
And what kind of defense were you doing, almighty king of the jungle?
The kind of defense only kings can do.
And what might that be?
King Fu!
King Fu!
King Fu!
No, wait a minute. I know my lion was more scared than anybody, but he sure saved me 3 or 4 times.
Yeah, that's right, Jack. And I would have done a lot more in there too, but right in the middle of it, I caught this here furball.
Yeah, he caught a furball.
A furball? Man, you are something else.
Yeah, you ain't nothing but a big old pussycat.
Meow, meow.
You don't know anything about it. Yes, you're right. A big old pussycat. That's all I ever am. And all I'll ever be. I won't.
There is a place.
It's Emerald City out there!
Look how beautiful it is!
Incredible!
Look at all that glitter!
I wonder if I can get a touch-up before we see the Wiz. No?
Hey, what's all this?
Looks like a bunch of flowers to me.
Yeah, and I suddenly have the urge to do a little cross-pollinated.
Oh no, this is the poppy's field! We gotta get out of here!
Hold your nose!
Don't breathe that stuff in!
No, wait! Y'all go ahead. I'll bring up the rear. I can't never find me no mouse when I need one, baby.
Okay, buddy. Now where'd you get those poppies from?
Poppies. Poppies! Actually, I'm from out of town, sir. I came here with the Lions Club.
Yeah, that's what they all say.
You're under arrest. Let's go.
Hey, wait a minute. I ain't doing nothing. You ain't paying for my clothes. I demand to see my owl. I said I demand to see Mama, Mama, Mama.
Dorothy, we're here. I don't believe it. Emerald City!
We finally made it through.
Now all we gotta do is find the Wiz!
And the lion.
Come on! Move along there, buddy!
There you are!
What happened?
Wait till my owl hears about this.
Look, I wanna tell you, your cat there was really flying.
We're sorry, officer. Very sorry.
Just make sure he doesn't go into their property field again, you hear?
Yes, sir. We'll try our very best. Man, what did you get yourself into?
Myself. Little mama. I almost found that rainbow.
Excuse me. But do you guys mind messing around in front of another city?
Who are you?
I am the royal gatekeeper. And we don't allow any trash here in the Big Green Apple.
We gotta go see the Wiz!
You must be mad. The Wiz never sees anyone, at any time or any place. But if you care to make it worth my while...
Oh! Is it worth your while to keep your knee bone connected to your shin bone?
All right!
Man, you better let us in this gate before I knock it down!
Okay, but first, you have to put on these green glasses.
Why?
Why? Because it's the law. That's why. Now, be gone.
Man, I ought to knock down this gate anyway.
I said, be gone! Well, there goes the neighborhood.
Funny.
Nobody sees the Wiz.
Why not?
They say he's so terrible to behold.
What's he look like?
A giant vulture.
A man-eating elephant.
A 9-foot dragon. And you? You want to see the Wiz? If you want to see the Wiz, honey, you go right ahead.
Fool around with me, will ya? I guess we can go in then.
I guess so.
Well, here goes.
Several pumps.
The good witch of the north.
Ah, out of her. How would you like to trade them for a beautiful emerald ring?
Ooh. Oh, I can't. I gotta keep them on till I get home. I made a promise.
Break it!
But I was taught to never break a promise.
You know, I can understand why a child like you wanted to go to Brazil. Mozambique, Mount Vernon. But Kansas, did I hear you correctly? Go back to Kansas?
Yes, sir.
And what's wrong with the pig?
Nothing.
Does my fantastic Emerald City please you?
Oh, no, sir. This is the most beautiful place I've ever seen. But there's my home, and there's Aunt Em and Uncle Henry. And Toto, I can't just forget them, can I?
You may do whatever you want. Besides, what is home but a place you leave anyway? Full of broken furniture, faded memories, shattered dreams. Why not forget it? Lion, what do you want?
To get the hell out of here. Oh.
Oh. Is that your only request?
Yes. And I agree. What's more to a home but broken furniture,
faded memories called oatmeal. And oh, if you only knew my mama.
But what is it you want?
Some courage.
You mean the mighty king of the jungle is a coward?
Only when I'm scared.
Weakness, that's your only strength. Scarecrow, are you a coward too?
A coward? Oh no, sir. I haven't got the brains to be afraid of anything.
Oh no?
Except fire. I know that much.
Not afraid of anything you thought. How little we know ourselves. Which is more deceptive? The foolish wise man or the wise fool?
The foolish wise man or the wise fool? Don't ask me. I've never been good with multiple choice.
Why are you upset on a straw? Tin Man, do you know anything or not?
Well, only that I want a heart, your wisdom.
What on earth for? Without one, you would never know pain, hurt, or sorrow.
But there's more to feeling than all that, right, your wisdom?
Possibly. But are you sure it's worth the suffering?
I'll take my chances. I'll take my chances.
If what?
If you kill the most evil, the most wicked, the most powerful of all witches of Oz, the Wicked Witch of the West. You had to kill one wicked witch.
But that was an accident.
I don't care how it happened. You're the best wicked witch killer in this country.
Say, Mr. Wiz, what do I have to do to get my brain?
Kill the Wicked Witch of the West, of course.
But you just told Dorothy she had to do that.
It doesn't matter who does it. This is a package deal. As long as the Wicked Witch of the West still lives, none of you guys get anything.
But I don't want to go around killing nobody.
Dorothy, if you want to get back home to Kansas bad enough, you would just have to pay for it.
But Mr. Witch!
No! I have spoken!
Bring me something, I see you. run for it.
Now, where's that Lord High Underling? You summoned me, oh beautiful mistress?
What's the situation with Dorothy?
I should have news from the front at any moment now. Good news.
On your knees when you speak to me. Now kiss my foot. Yeah! Woo! One more time. A little height. And about an inch to the bust. It's so good to be a liberated woman.
Your evilness.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, for your sake, it had better be good news.
Oh, yeah. I got a really piece of good news for you. Mostly.
Mostly?
Yeah.
What do you mean by mostly?
Well, firstly, Dorothy and her friends are still on their way here, and they're gonna do you in.
What?
We weren't able to get the silver slippers away from Dorothy.
What?
And thirdly, I gotta go now.
But you brought me nothing but bad news. Where's the good news you promised?
Good news is, there ain't no more bad news.
Who hired this jive turkey?
Well, I did. Why?
Well, a pox on your hat.
A pox on my house.
A pox on both of your houses.
My summer place too?
Oh, shut up. Well, I know it's not your fault.
No, it's not my fault.
So I'm going to be very fair about this.
Yes, very fair. Can I go now?
Hang that sucker!
No!
The knots got. I'm gonna summon my winged monkeys.
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
Not the winged monkeys!
Boom! Shakalaka! Boom! Shakalaka! Boom! Shakalaka!
Okay, baby. I'm here. It's not because of you, it's because of that dumb chin.
Don't you come signify me, you little ape! Or I'll put a spell on your coconuts.
Okay. What are you gonna land me in the gang this time?
Something right up your alley. A couple of cats that needs to be straightened out.
Gotcha. Who?
A scarecrow, a tin man, a lion, and a little brat named Dorothy.
A scarecrow, a tin man, a lion, and a little brat named Dorothy. You don't get along with nobody, do you?
Oh, shut up! And do as I command. Once I get my hands on Dorothy's silver slippers, all of us will kiss my feet.
Thank you.
Dorothy!
Flying!
Are you all right?
I guess so. What's that old witch got you doing?
Carrying all this water out of this place.
They got you carrying water?
Little mama, they got me feeling like Gunga Din. Child, you know that lady's so afraid of water, she don't even take a bath?
She doesn't?
No, she just sends herself out to be dry cleaned.
We've got them all and we're gonna have straw soup. Well, well, well. I don't remember telling anyone to take five.
Oh, please, Mrs. Witch, I haven't seen the line since I've been here.
So what? Just get back to work. I want you to scrub the floors, polish the silver, vacuum the rugs, and you do windows, don't you? And you, get that water out of my sight! Dorothy, wait. When are you gonna give me those lovely silver slippers?
I can't.
I'll give you all my beauty tips.
Oh, Lord, Mama. Don't nobody want those.
I'll never take my shoes.
Get that to me, you little brat.
Big Mama, do you know what my owl would say about you?
Owl? No.
You what? Crazy.
Is that a put down?
No, your fatness.
Your fatness? For that, I'ma have your hide.
Don't tell me I've done it again.
Because we want to see the wizard again, big dummy.
Impossible. He moved.
He moved? How come?
I don't know. Something about an urban renewal.
Well, you better urban this gate.
I can't. You see, the man with the keys went on vacation until about the middle of next month.
Well, you tell him to take his vacation some other time.
Well, I guess we'd better leave the money and go.
Money? What money?
Well, we brought back this big bag of loot for the Wiz. How much do you think is in here, Brother Lion?
Bag, what bag? Oh, well, between the gold and silver alone, I'd say somewhere in the vicinity of, round figure.
I think there's twice as much.
So, when the man with the keys comes back, the money will be right here by the mail chute. Come on, Dorothy, we gotta be going.
Gold? Silver? Where?
Gotcha!
Oh, damn! I fall for this every night.
We're going in to see the witch.
All right, fine. But I don't want to be in there when you wake him up. And don't go around touching anything. You see with your eyes, not your hands.
Would you say the lady was liquidated?
I wonder where he is.
I am everywhere.
Well, we come to get what you promised.
I'm busy.
Busy? What kind of stuff is that?
It's a cop-out.
Hey, you guys. I think I found the engine room.
Go away!
Turn the crank!
Go away!
The mask is moving! Turn some more!
Go away! No!
Have you seen Mr. Wiz?
No, I haven't. As a matter of fact, the Wiz is not here right now.
Then who are you?
I'm
a fake! A fraud!
A phony!
And hell!
And you look just like any other person in the morning.
Who do you think you are? Tell me how. How did you go so far? The show is over. The rain is down and you got to come free. The sun is down. You must rise up. Say what you mean.
is the great, the terrible, the omnipotent Wizard of Oz reality.
Yeah?
Just a former nobody from Omaha, Nebraska.
Nebraska? Why, that's near Kansas.
Yep, it's right next door.
I don't understand.
Of course not. Nobody knows my secret until now. Ever sees the real me. Look, y'all, all I ever wanted was the simple things in life. Power, prestige, and money. I tried everything back in Omaha. I sold used cars, I was a pitch man in the carnival, I even peddled bleach and cream from door to door. But nothing ever worked. Until one day, I got the call.
The call?
The call from who?
The call from the Almighty himself. And the voice said to me, son, what you ought to do is spread the good word. And I said, why? And the voice said to me, for the simple things in life. Power, prestige, and money.
So, some almighty voice said all that to you?
Well, I can't swear if the message was live or in tape, but I heard it clear as the bell.
Then what happened?
Well, the very next day, I read where there was 5,000 people coming together to join the county fair.
Yeah?
So, I rented myself a hot air balloon.
Why?
Well, check this out. I come floating out of the clouds, and I laid my maiden message on the multitude, and I whipped up the granddaddy of all revival meetings. Now, unfortunately, as my balloon was coming over the carousel, out of nowhere, a violent windstorm came up, and the next thing I knew, I landed right here in Oz, right in the middle of the ladies' social.
Come, 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 Mr. Wiz. What happened next, my man?
Well, these ladies had never seen a balloon before. They thought a miracle had delivered me to them. And before you could say wizard, they promoted me all over town and sold tickets for the benefit. At which they said I was gonna perform another miracle. Naturally, I did.
Well, yeah, but what kind of another miracle did you wear from Cats and Kittens?
Ah, green glasses.
Say what?
The glasses with the green lenses, like the ones everyone's wearing. Just like the one I was wearing when I landed here.
Yeah, but they ain't no big deal about a pair of green shades, is there?
The miracle, my friend, is where you allow your eyes to see through them.
Something else but a bunch of straw up here.
I could find green glasses for them, all of them out there, maybe I could find some brains in here for you. Look what we got here, all brains. For the miracle of modern science, they have dehydrated, pre-frozen, a distillation of some of the best brains in the world. We're gonna restock your head with some of this.
I finally know where my head is at.
A heart, you say?
Yeah.
Then a heart it shall be. You know what?
Yeah.
A beautiful young lady gave her heart to me. Now I give it to you.
Are the batteries included?
And no extra charge.
All you fine ladies out there, you better watch out. I see Rick in the front room. Who's in the back?
Oh, baby, I see you. As for you, Jack, I bet a couple of the totes of the Emerald City Courage Potion will do the trick. Drink. I'm sorry. I could do a lot of things for a lot of people, but I just don't know how to get you back home to Kansas. The answer's not in that box.
Of course not. It's out there somewhere.
Out where?
Tell me, my good fellow. Do you still have the balloon that got you here? From Kansas?
Yes, I do. The ladies put it in the park. We made a national shrine out of it.
Just as I thought. Now, if that balloon got you here from Nebraska, why couldn't it take Dorothea back to Kansas?
Well, it certainly could.
Yeah, when do we go?
But first of all, there is no way you're gonna get me to leave all of this. All my power, prestige, and my money.
You mean your big old empty room where nobody comes to see you, and you're afraid to go out lest people find out you're fooling them?
I am not afraid. I just keep a low profile.
I bet if you got started all over someplace...
Oh, no.
You can do all this and maybe have some friends.
Friends? Do you really think so?
Aw. You're not so bad once a person gets to know you.
Friends, huh?
And when we get back to Kansas, I'll give you my silver slippers.
Well, what are we waiting for? My friends, on this memorable day when friends must part, remember to everything, there's a season and a time to keep and a time to cast away. Mm. Yes, I said a time to keep and a time to cast away. And there's no time for us today. Yes, I said a time to keep, I said a time to keep and a time to remember. And at this very same and embrace what we fear, ourselves and all our beautiful hang-ups. We have got to know in our hearts that the things that we hold as sacred are sometimes holding us down. When we fucking up, down, afraid to wade through the strange and troubling waters, down, burning in the truth of our own lives. When we're supposed to be reaching up, 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 to touch the fingers of frozen truth, to find out who we truly are. You gotta pull up all your clothes to find out who you are. Y'all gonna do it?
No.
Shall I do it?
Yeah.
Ooh, I have done it. I have stepped outside of myself in order to see what I ought to have seen before. Now you guys have to do it. It's not enough to know where you're going. You also have to know where you're coming from. Y'all got it?
Got it.
So I'll pack my bag and I'm rolling. I got a date, so don't you ask me to stay, cause I'm so vain. You were always ready, for you was a dream. Must have thought that little quick and easy to me. Here's what I did to it, put it up on the shelf. But now it's time for this wind to win on himself. And I'm whizzing. Oh, y'all hope a whole lot of magic from me. But that's the greatest magic that you ever see. If you think it more than one time, the game won't be gone. And you will have to hold up to the rest on your own. Ain't no way to think about that.
Join the circus, child?
No, these are my friends. They came with me to see the Wiz.
You saw him? And you got what you wanted?
They did, but I still haven't gotten home to Kansas.
Well, listen, don't worry about it. Maybe my sister Glinda ought to be able to do something.
Who?
Glinda, my sister. Remember I told you about her. She's the prettiest of all us witches. Takes after me.
Where can we find her?
Oh, don't worry. I'll have Glinda here before you can say great Googa Moonga Shooga Booga. Just a wave from our wonga. Listen, that's Glinda's theme song. Oh, look at her. She's coming straight out of the woodworks. Go ahead and work the show, Glinda, baby.
Look at the trip you've made.
mother sure nor forget no none.
Well, it may be so, but it sure cost me a fortune to do it. Now, come over here, darling.
Miss Glinda, my name's Dorothy, and these are my friends.
I know all about you.
You do?
Oh, I've been watching you on my crystal ball, hopping around from one witch to another, hitting them with houses, and washing them down the drain.
Yeah, nobody knows the trouble I've seen.
Well, relax, child. Ha, pussycat.
Then you help me get home again?
Why, honey, you got your silver slippers. They'll take you home in no time. And don't you ever talk to your feet?
No.
Well, add a pearl. Add a pearl. Add a pearl. Yes? You know you could have just told her the secret right off.
Yeah, I could have.
But look at all the people I'd be putting out of work.
Something, little mama. I guess it's about time for you to go home, huh?
Just think. You could have went home before you met me.
Yeah. Before you got caught up with any of us. Oh, honey, what a shame.
No, it's not a shame. Because if I went back then, I would have never seen you get your heart. And I would have never known if you got your brains. And you.
Oh, Dorothy. Do you really have to go?
Well, logically. Even if she did go, if you kept the silver slippers, you could come back anytime you wanted.
And I will, Scarecrow, I will. But right now, don't you all see? And I think of home, I think of home.
And that makes the tall grass
hope you liked it. Look at these beautiful children. Oh, you have a speech. Oh,
okay. These are for you. We just want to thank you so much for your love and support and for giving us a grand opportunity and for making this beautiful auditorium for us so we can do our shows. And my teacher, Ms. Paul, the pit, the band, the parents that helped us, the staff. I'd like to take over.
She was doing my speech. She was doing my speech. This is Mary and Sadie Khan, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, she's been in every single show I've directed, from Lion King to Suzico to Charlie Brown to Little Celie and the Color Purple. Like all of these students on the stage, they're going places. They're going places. Yes, definitely. So you know it takes a village to put this show together. I didn't do it all by myself. So I have to start with, not in any particular order, Miss Angela Hall, vocal music teacher. She did the vocals for the show. She did the music for the pit. She's a teacher in our school. Miss Monica Johnson, choreographer. Come up on the stage, come up on the stage. Monica Johnson, choreography, dance teacher. Sam Reed, our teaching assistant. He did a lot of the choreography as well. Miss Janet Rush, she designed the set. Every set we've ever had. Miss Janet Rush, come to the stage. Miss Gladys James, our costume designer. Every costume, every time you've seen the show. Where's Miss James? She coming? Excellent. Antoinette is on lights in the back. I have to write notes because sometimes I forget. Chad is on sound in the back. Miss Karen Wheeler, who designed all the props. She's a teacher in the school as well. Joseph Dempsey, production stage manager. Jessica Lakativa, stage manager. Then let's go to, yes, come on up. The pit over here are the musical theater students. Give them some love. Stand up, guys, stand up. Stand up. All that singing, you heard them. That's these babies right here. My assistant principal, but also singing in the pit, Miss Andrea Thomas. Professional actor extraordinaire, Mr. James Alexander. My phenomenal stream students, they play all over the country. If you ask me, stream students, stand up. Miss Jamila Joseph, this is her first time with us, but she's a teacher in the district. Stand up, baby. Norma Lisa Thomas, who taught the string students their music, is also the orchestra director who makes sure our kids play everywhere from Orlando to New Mexico. I'm just making that up. But Norma Lisa Thomas, stand up. Nelson in the pit right here on keyboard. Alva, stand up. Yes, you. Ayomale, my brother, on the guitar. The reason our band sounds like something, all of them play Broadway, so that's why you get the flavor of Broadway musicians. Patience Higgins over here on woodwind. Mansigori, our teacher in the Arts Magnet School. Over here on the drums. And look who's behind him, Justice Lee. Stand up, Justin. Are you standing? Diego Torres on guitar. Amari Rockabo on horn. Stand up. I know I messed up your name. Malachi Walton on organs. Last but not least, my brother I've known forever and ever and ever and ever, who flies in whenever I ask him to, who puts the whole band, everything together. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Alvin Waddles. Yes. Jackie Hyatt, assistant to the costume designer. Where are you, Jackie? Holly Ayers, my assistant. Vanessa Newby, hair and makeup. Ladies, come to the stage. And we're the cosmetology students from Mount Vernon High School. Who have, come on out. Mount Vernon High School, cosmetology students. Where's the tech crew? All my visual arts students. Come on out, guys. Where's Miss Chance? Yes, where are they? Come on out, guys. Come right here. Come on. Come on. Slide it down. 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 Vincent Miller on videography, all of our posters and pictures. Where's Chance? Is she here? Chance? I didn't want to forget her. She's everything. Everything I do, she does too. Just a smaller version. She is. My parents, all of the parents who work on the show, who work out in the audience. My security team, where are you guys? Wonderful. My administrative team, Ms. LaTanya Beavers, Natasha Freeman Mack, Cletus Witte. I'm forgetting somebody. Charles Brown, yes, my assistant principal. They all worked on the show. The National Honor Society and the National Junior Honor Society for ushering. They were the children in black. I think that's it. So on behalf of the Performing and Visual Arts Magnet Program, our superintendent, Dr. Kenneth R. Hamilton, we thank you for coming out. We thank you for giving our children this love. We appreciate you. We'll keep in touch and let you know what we're doing next. Thank you guys so much. We appreciate it. Thank you.